Hi, my name is Medhat Elmasry. Today's video is about how to create a master detail web application using ASP.NET Razor Pages. We will create a master detail web application where the data originates from your operating system. Specifically, we will query the local operating system so that it provides us with the number of processes that are running. We will then display details about each specific process. It is assumed that you have .NET 6.0 installed on your computer and that you also have Visual Studio Code installed on your computer. So let us get started. Let us create a Razor Pages app in one of our working directories. So for that, I'm going to type in .NET new, and to create a Razor Pages app, you either enter Razor or you can also use web app. Both of them work. And the output directory would be, I will call it OS process. Now let's move into that directory. Let us first open the app in code by typing in code dot, and this will open it up in Visual Studio Code. Next thing is we can run our application in watch mode. So the command for that is .NET watch run. Now watch mode allows the server to restart whenever there are changes to any of the code in the file system. So if you do that, it will open up the application in your default browser. This is what the application looks like. There are two tabs. There is home and privacy. Let's replace the home page with a list of processes that are running in your operating system. So to do that, we will go under pages, and this is the view for your home page, and this is the code behind for your home page. So we'll open the code behind for your home page and import the namespace that we need, and that is system diagnostics. Now, in the onget method, we will read all the processes that are running into an array of process objects. So declaration will be an array of process objects, and we're going to call the variable processes. And using the process class, we just call a method called getProcesses, and this reads all the processes running in the operating system. Now, I will use the view data dictionary to pass the information from the code behind to the view. So I will use view data, and the key, I will simply call it P, and that will take the value of this array containing all the processes. The next step is to go into the view, which is the index.cshtml. In here, I'm going to take the data that comes in your view data, the key being P. I'm going to convert this into a process array, but of course before I do that, I need to import this namespace. So I'm going to say at using system.diagnostics, and now I can cast this object that's in the dictionary as an array of process objects, and I'll assign that to an array of process objects which I will call processes. And it should do it. Now we get a warning here saying that converting non-literal or possible null value. In other words, this is possibly going to be a null array. So the way to fix that is to put a question mark beside the declaration of a process array. Next, let us delete this here. We will display all the processes running by iterating through this processes array. To do that, we'll do a for each loop, and we'll iterate through the processes array, and we'll check for each element in the array that the process name is not empty. So I'm going to say if string is null or empty, and we're going to check the item.process name. If it is not empty, then we are going to display the process name in a paragraph. So we're going to say at item.process name. We have a warning here, and the way to get around the warning for the processes variable is to put an exclamation mark, and it should go away. Now let's look at our page, and you can see here there are many processes that are running on our computer. Let me create a link on this process name so that when I click on it, it takes me to another page that displays the details of that particular process. So for that, I'm going to put an anchor here and it will point to ASP-page, and I'm going to create a details page. So I'm going to put ./details because it would be in the same folder. And the route, ASP route ID, is going to be the items ID or the process ID, which it would be item.id. So we'll close the anchor tag here. This would be the anchor tag there. And let's move this after the name of the process, which is here, and that should do it. So we have an anchor tag, and this points to this page, and it's going to pass the route. I think I have an extra tag here, and it's going to display the process name. And let's go back here, and you'll see that we have a link. When we click on this link, nothing happens, and this is because we don't have a details page yet. ASP.NET allows us to scaffold pages using the .NET new command. So I'm going to stop the web server here and execute a command that will scaffold for me a details page. That would be .NET new page, and the namespace would be OS process, which is the name of my app.pages. And the name of my page is going to be simply details. And the output directory would be the pages folder. So we have an error here. I made a typo with namespace. Namespace. And this is done successfully. Let's go back into VS Code and see where that page is. And here it is. We have a details.cshtml and a details.cshtml.cs page. In the .cs page onGet method, we're going to change the signature so that it receives an ID. And just like we did before, we're going to import the system.diagnostics namespace. And here we can feed the view data item with key P with the details about the process with ID equals to this ID. So we call the method getProcessById and pass it on the ID, and that's about it. Next, let's go to the view, which is details.cshtml here, and let's import the system.diagnostics namespace. So we use using system.diagnostics. And over here, just like we did before, we're going to take that process object that's in the view data dictionary, cast it as a process object, and assign it to a variable. So I'm going to say process question mark because it's nullable. I'm going to call the variable process equals to view data with key P, and we're going to cast this as a process object. And I can display a message here using view data again, and I'm going to put it in a key called title, and the value of this title is going to be a string where I'm going to say the process with ID equals to, and I'll display this variable process and the ID. Now, because this is nullable, I'll put the exclamation mark. So that should do it. The next thing is to display this title. So let me display that title in an H1 tag. So I can say at view data, and the key is title. Our next task is to display the details. So I'll do that in a bootstrap table. So I'm going to have a table with class equals to table, and to make it look nicer, I'm going to use the table striped bootstrap class. Next, I'll create a table row, and I'd like to have two cells. So I'll just copy this. And since I need to have two more of these, I'll just display some data about these processes, not everything, because we don't really want to waste too much time. So I'll copy this again. So the first thing we want to display is process name, and the data for that will come from process.processName. And here it is. The next thing we want to display is the start time. When did that process start? That would be at process.startTime. The next thing we want to display is the number of threads associated with that process. So I'm going to type in number of threads, and the data comes from at process.threads.count. I think let's go back to our application. Let us start it here and see what it looks like. You can see now that we have a link that points to, if you look at the message down here in the bottom left corner of the browser, it points to /details?ID=2, and we can pass the ID. So let me click on say registry here. So it says access denied. So it looks like one of the properties is restricted. We cannot view the property because of access rights. So if that's the case, I'm just going to comment out this particular property and go back and restart again. And let's go back. Here we go. I'm going to click on win init, and there you go. We're able to see the details. Let me put a link here to take us back to the home page. So to do that, I'm going to come under the table, open a div here, and put an anchor with ASP page that takes me to the index page. And I'll say here back to list. Let's see how that works. Restart our page and then go back to the root. Click on one of these and then I have back to list. I can see the details of each one of these. Now there's another way of sending data from the code behind into the view if you do not want to use view data. And this is by using something called the proper. Let's look at that approach. So now if I go to the index.cshtml, I can add a property here that represents the array of processes. So I'm going to go prop
and tab, and the property type is going to be an ILIST of process object, and I'm going to call these processes, and I'll set
the default to be not nullable instead of this, which I will comment out at the moment because we're going to use a different system. I'm going to say process equals to essentially this, so it's going to get the processes and assign them into this processes. This variable, in fact, I made a mistake. Let me copy this. It is correct. So basically, it's this variable. Copy and paste it here just to make sure it is correct. In the view, which is index.cshtml, I'm going to comment this out because I do not need this. And instead of iterating through the processes variable, which is declared here, I'm going to iterate through the model.processes. This is a property in the model, and the rest will be the same. If I run this application now, it should behave just like before. As you can see here, if I refresh, everything works like before. Now, there's one other thing that I would like to do is to also use the same property approach with the details page. So that would mean that we should go to the details page, the code behind, and here we create also another property for the individual processes. So in the details.cshtml file, I'm going to declare a property for a single process. And this is the way it would look like. And instead of using view data, I'm going to assign a value to this one single process. And that would be equals to this. We can go to the details view, and instead of using view data to access the process, I'm just going to use the model. So I'm going to type in here model.singleProcess. There it is. And here, these would all be model.singleProcess. And copy it here. Model.singleProcess. There you are. If I click on any single process like this one, it will show me the details and I can go back to the list and so on and so forth. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you like it, please give it a thumbs up. Thank you, and until we meet at the next video, take care.